Hi everyone, Total Quality Management, TQM. TQM applied to education. As was mentioning in the previous episode, after the Second World War, the concept of TQM was suggested in United States by Edward Deming. But it was not taken seriously. But Japanese took it seriously, and that was the beginning of the supremacy of Japanese industry globally. Now we are applying the same concept of total quality management in education. Look at the various products we're using. Look at the television, the automobile, the two-wheelers, the smartphones. All these things are products. Education also is a product. Actually, education is the foundation of all products. Like, time is the foundation of anything. So, we need to be looking at a product which will stand the test of time. Technology will make it different. There are two words, make a note of this: methodology and technology. Methodology is set of steps. Now, I install a computer, and I'm given a set of steps to boot. And I go through the steps and my computer boots. Methodology. One day, I boot my computer, nothing happens. Right? And so my methodology has failed. Then I ask my service provider. He tells me, do this, do this, do this. I do that. The computer boots. So methodology will help us to get things done following the steps. But technology will help you to troubleshoot. That's the difference between methodology and technology. That's why new technologies are coming. Just imagine the last 50 years. A road is not laid the way it was laid 40 years ago. An automobile is not produced the way it was produced 40 years ago. A television set is not assembled the way it was assembled 40 years ago. Why for that? Go ask your wife or mother. A kitchen is not the way it was 40 years ago today. Look at the technology that has invaded everywhere. On the road, in the organization, in the kitchen, in the hall, in the drawing room. So technology innovation, technology adaption is important in education also. The last 20 years have seen a lot of technology introduction in classrooms. Blackboard has gone forever and whiteboard came. That was the first ever technology. No chalk piece. Even in chalk piece, dust-free chalk piece came. That was another technology. And then smart board came. Introduction of visuals came. A teacher need not draw the picture of a heart. It's already made. Then came the smart boards with computer connected, LAN connected, server connected. A teacher has to walk in only maybe with a PowerPoint USB or a thumb drive. And in the last couple of years, thanks to COVID, the technology of online education has started. A teacher is far away. No, remember the story Vekaleva? who studied the archery with the just with the drawing of picture of Dronacharya. So today's Ekalai was are learning from home, and Dronacharyas are teaching from their house. That is the technology. All these things are physical products, please understand. Your smart TV, your smart classroom, your television set, all those things are materials, solid things, piece you can see. But the most important technology in education is the introduction of the technology of teaching. The technology of managing a school. The technology of managing the various resources at the hand of the educator. That is TKM. In fact, in this series of presentation, I'm going to give you an overview. With this, let me give an introduction to the beautiful, the most important word, change. When Barack Obama got elected, he used only this word, change, that made a big difference in the history of the United States of America. Change is permanent. Change is the only thing which does not change. Right? I recall a quote of Charles Darwin. It's not the strongest of the species which survives, but the one which is most adaptable to change. It's not the strongest of the species which survives. Huge organizations are not there today. New companies have overtaken old organizations. I was reading somewhere, why did dinosaurs as a species die? I'm sure you would have seen the movie Jurassic Park. Huge animals. Not at all comparable with with all the gadgets of machine gun in the hands of a human being. Huge. How did they die? If the strongest of the species should survive, then the dinosaurs should have survived. But look at it, what's happening? Human beings are surviving millions and millions of years. You take the origin of human beings, at the origin, how many species were there? And today, how many species are there, including human beings? What happened to the population of elephants? Population of lion, tiger, leave alone dinosaurs. I read somewhere that one of the reasons why dinosaurs died, the dinosaurs are forest animals. If a dinosaur is bitten by a poisonous snake, it will take 3 months for the information to reach the brain that it has been bitten by a poisonous snake, by the time the dinosaurs will die. So this is what is called the reflex time. Something takes place, and how fast you respond is very, very important. So the time between a change taking place and you are responding to change is very, very important. And so this is the time when we talk about a major revolution in the education field through NEP, we have to switch over to TKM, because organizations have switched over long ago. Today, TKM is a common household name in any organization. Right? So with that, let me take you through what happened to those organizations which did not change. Do you know what is this? What is this? I used to show this in my managing change seminars. You may say it's a generator or it's a transformer or some machine. But you'll be surprised. This is in 1956. It is the storage device of a 5 MB memory. But today you have a 128 GB thumb drive. Right? Imagine the first computer which occupied a room. And today there is computer everywhere. In the camera in front of me, there is a computer. In this, there is a computer. At the door, there is a computer. In the car, there are about 10 computers. Now, tell me, if I say I have a factory like this, I can produce the best ever transformer of this size, who will buy it? The question is, are we changing with time? Is our technology changing? If a product is changing? Now, that brings me to the various things that these are all some of the Tamil advertisements. Once I went to the oldest of the dailies, newspapers, magazines, and took a photograph of old advertisements. These are all about 75-year-old advertisements. As you can see it from the color of the paper. There was a time when Planters tea was popular. Now find out where those teas are today. Toothpaste, Kolinas toothpaste. Go ask your grandparents, they will tell you Kolinas. I have used it. Now, Kolinas toothpaste was once a wonderful toothpaste, but what happened now? His master's voice. Remember the disc? And the jukebox with 25 paisa, you can drop it, you can listen to the music, the record player. If we produce the same record player, or if we produce music through the same record player, who will buy it? Now, look at this. This is the type of advertisement in Tamil. It reads that this is a new movie. This is how the ad agencies are functioning. This is another advertisement. Indian tea, 75 years ago, market leader. What happened? Philips milk of magnesia. Go and ask your grandparents. I remember buying it. Whenever a baby has some stomach upset, Philips milk of magnesia. What happened now? Parker pens. Once it used to be a prestige pen, Parker pen. Where is it available? Yes, some of us may be having it, but what is the market share? Out of 100 pens in 100 different pockets of people, how many of them will be Parker pens? It is another advertisement of a textile shop in Coimbatore, famous. I have seen this long, long, long ago. But where are they today? Again, his master's voice. Now, this is interesting. Faber-Lubbe watches. See this, 1946, this is the date of this advertisement. In 1946, this magazine carried an ad, Faber-Lubbe watches. Faber-Lubbe watches, Parker pens. Right? Now, what happened to Faber-Lubbe watches today? Again, Kamadenu, Vanaspati. What happened? Sunlight soap. Do you have sunlight soap today? Johnson & Johnson. After all these lights, there is one product. Johnson & Johnson is still in the market. Why? Change of product, change of process, change the concept which changed the fate of this company. I would have shown you about 20, 25 slides now. First ever one product, one company which survives today because it introduced changes. Again, there is another bar soap, which was once the market leader. 501, this is a trade name, 501 special. This is the detergent soap. What happened to the detergent today? When did we first come across the powder, detergent powder? We were all used to a solid detergent powder, detergent cake. again the same brand, Dalda. Now this is a very interesting trade name, Dalda. I remember during my school days purchasing Dalda Vanaspati. What happened to Dalda today? Ajax. Again, this brand is still available. This is the emery powder, emery sheet we talk about. Go to a carpenter, he will ask you to buy emery sheets. Ajax. Again, a 100-year-old company, it is still today available. Doing well. Why? Change. Ponds. Once again, one more company. Johnson & Johnson we saw. Ajax we saw. Now Ponds. It is surviving even today. It's doing well today. Why? Adapting to changes. This is a very popular daily in Tamil Nadu. Dinathandi. Like maybe Times of India, Hindu, Deccan Herald. If you go to Dinathandi office, take the newspaper of 1943 and take today's Dinathandi, put them side to side. You will know how the product has changed. How the process of producing a newspaper has changed. How the process of reporting has changed. How the process of distribution has changed. Focus has changed. Tenor cigarettes. It used to be the market leader once. What happened today? Lifebuoy. So even today it is available. But those days Lifebuoy soaps used to be so big. But today look at the flavor. There used to be only one flavor those days. But look at the flavor. Rose and sandal and jasmine. Packaging has changed. Production process has changed. Godrej. Yes. It has survived. But the shaving, these products have changed. They're talking about shaving systems. So companies which have adopted to change have survived. This is interesting. Madras Pencil Factory used to be a famous company down south. Madras Pencil Factory, own company. Again, very old, and more than 50, 60 years ago. Mysore Sandal Soap. Yes, one more company which is existing even today. But the product has changed. The process has changed. The technology has changed. Horlicks. Again, one more product. But it used to be considered as a sick man's drink, quote unquote. Whenever somebody is sick, we used to go with the Horlicks. But look at the branding today. It's not anymore a sick man's drink. It is a healthy drink. And look at the products for doctors, for students, for babies, for pregnant mothers. So change is the keyword. Cutigra. Talcum powder. I remember my mother having this Cutigra talcum powder. When we behaved like good children, she will give a small little speck of that Cutigra powder. But today, what happened to Cutigra powder? Maybe it is there, but the question is, what is the market share? Ovaltine. Maybe abroad it is there, but in how many houses they will have Ovaltine? Again, old advertisements. Again, it's a betel nut, Ashoka betel nut. Gopal Balpudi, down south, very popular. Brahmi oil. Suvega, I'm sorry, it is Ulta. Suvega was the first ever moped which came to, at least I remember, in South India. But what happened to Suvega today? Right. So, Ajax, I already told you. Zefrol. McLean, again it is Ulta, McLean toothpaste, SR toothpaste, West End watches. Now, if we have to change, if we have to survive, there are two alternatives. Work hard. You see the picture? Square wheels. And one has to push. Somebody has to pull. This is what is happening in many educational fields. Everybody is tensed. The parents are tensed, pushing the children to read. The children are tensed, carrying heavy workload. Is this the way we want to run an organization? Is this the way we want to run a school? But look at this. The same thing, look at the ease with which this boy is pulling, the ease with which the participation of parents in the education process. What is the difference? Now look at the difference. The round wheels were already there. They did not bring anything new. It took some time for them to realize the round wheels are available. Why not I change the square wheels to round wheels? And so this transition took place. Now this is what I call it as technology introduction. Technology of teaching, technology of running a school has to change. And that's why we are talking about TQM approach. Let me end this with a famous quotation I saw somewhere. There is a forest. And in the forest, every day a lion wakes up. And the lion knows that unless and until it runs faster than the fastest deer, it will starve to death. In the same forest, a deer wakes up. And the deer knows that it has to run faster than the fastest lion or it will be killed. And so it does not matter whether you are a lion or a deer, when the morning comes up, keep running. And so this is the compulsion today. This is the compulsion. We have to look at total quality management as the only survival tool. The survival of an organization depends on the total quality management, a comprehensive organization-wide change. Same thing applies to a school. Gone are the days when you can punish a child and make him to read. Gone are the days when you can reward a teacher and make her to teach. Gone are the days when you can threaten a parent and ask him to do what he wants to do, what he has to do. Today, we have to adapt the TQM model, which is a very comprehensive model system, which we are going to discuss segment by segment in the future episodes. As I said, this is theoretical presentation. The workshop will be very comprehensive. If you are not subscribed to this channel, please do subscribe and press the bell button so that you will get the latest update. If you have any comments, please post it in the comment box and I will try to answer. All the best. See you in the next episode.
ABS Vidya Mandir, Tiruvallur. ABS Vidya